Tapi yang jadi masalah dalam negara kita, dia dah sampai ke peringkat mencipta fitnah. Mereka fitnah. Ini yang jadi bahaya. Yang saya sebutlah semalam. Kan, contohnya macam cubaan untuk membabitkan Yang Amat Mohamad Perdana Menteri dalam kes pembunuhan Altuntuyah. Benda yang tak ada, daripada benda yang tak ada cuba diwujudkan supaya ada. Dengan menggunakan surat akuan sumpah contoh dia. Kan? Oleh kata contoh oleh siapa nama tu? Balas Surabaniam. Yang saya sendiri terlibat. Semasa kes tu dia tak cakap apa pun. Dia macam mana tiba-tiba sekarang macam-macam dia keluar cerita kan? Saya membela dengan Azilah, Chief Inspector Azilah tu. Semasa tu Bala tak ada cakap apa-apa pasal yang apa yang disebut sekarang lah. Langsung tak ada. Ya, itu pada saya, itu maksud saya tahap fitnah tu sampai ke tahap mereka. Kan? Pada saya kalau masa perbicaraan pun tak sebut, kepada polis pun masa siasatan tak sebut, tiba-tiba sekarang baru sebut. Kan? Dan dia pula mengaku ambil duit lah macam-macam. Jadi kita nampaklah modus operandi. Kalau ikut apa yang saya biasa buat, modus operandi tu sama. Sama. Get somebody that can link to the case and get the best mechanism sekarang ni SD lah. Dua SD yang berbeza. Dan saya tengok ini kalau ikut modus operandi dia, sengaja dibuat seolah-olah menunjukkan bahawa setelah mendedahkan kebenaran dia dipaksa oleh polis, dipaksa oleh orang tertentu untuk tukar buat pengakuan, terpaksa pergi luar negeri. The whole thing you see is a package. For me it's a package to give credibility to the SD, the initial SD. And the same modus operandi. Kalau kita tengok KK lain pun sama aje. Style dia sama. So yeah, the target is to just create doubt. Just to create doubt. The problem is a political expediency at all cost. This is dangerous. This is dangerous for the country. Orang-orang yang ada kepentingan lah. Kita orang kata you put two and two together lah. Siapa yang akan dapat benefit daripada semua ni? Then you can identify lah. No, tak ada. There's no mention at all of the Prime Minister or the yang apa nama Datin Seri Rosmah Mansur. No mention at all. So I was shocked. Dia kata, macam mana dia orang boleh kait? That the police is investigating. Yes, that one I agree. They are investigating the thing. I also want to know. So I want to wait for the police to complete their investigation on Bala. Yeah. So my advice to Bala is to come forward. Why must you hide? You come forward. Tell the truth. Because of the third party. I don't think if I continue, I believe at that time, if I continue with the defense, I would compromise my position as a lawyer because I was his lawyer. So I felt that at that point of time it's not viable anymore for me to proceed. Just like I withdraw from the Kazakh case involving Datuk Sri Anwar, because I reached a stage where I think I would compromise my position if I continue. It's not good for the client. See? Because at the end of the day, you are talking about representing a client. So it's not in the interest of my client for me to proceed. So I withdraw. That's the reason. Because the pressure to link the Prime Minister, at the time he was the Deputy Prime Minister, to the murder, I think it will compromise my position as a lawyer. So I withdraw. Better to withdraw. Definitely. Definitely. The same modus operandi. the same modus operandi. Once you create doubt over the AG or the IGP or certain other people like the ketua pengarah SPRM, you are attacking the institution. And I was reading the report by the National Operation Council 1969. You can see the similarity. The pattern is there. Target the institution. Target Regiment Askar Melayu Diraja, target the Police Diraja Malaysia, target Sultan, target institusi-institusi Melayu. You see the same pattern. It's being repeated here. Exactly. You see the speeches, you see the apa perarakan keranda tu is, you know, kita pun ada perarakan keranda sekarang, you know, orang ni mati kena bunuh lah, apalah macam-macam. Similar, almost exactly similar, and some of the character then are still here. You know, some of the character in 1969 are still here, playing a dominant role. Which is very, for me, is very interesting to see the development, because the pattern are the same. Attack the institution. Then they use communism. Then, now they are using human rights, but the pattern are the same. You can see this, the pattern are the same. I was surprised, and you know, I'm almost 50, you know. So I bukan 25 tau. I'm almost 50. I have never read that report. To be frank with you, I've never read the National Operation Council report on May 13. What actually happened? For the first time, to prepare my speech, I read it, and I found a lot of things that I didn't know. Which, if you apply it now, it's the same pattern, and that really shocked me. Actually, I'm writing something on it now. You know, you see the speeches then, as reported in the council's report, the speeches is almost the same. You know, go to hell with the Malay lah, hapolah itulah. You can see that. It is, yes. It's a threat to the country. And I'm surprised the government not doing anything. You know, I was thinking that the government should come down hard, because if the government read the National Operation Council's report 1969, they can see the similarity in pattern of what they are doing now. Same thing. Yes. I think the government should come up with a maybe even a royal commission. If need to, because we are talking about the security of the country and the future of the nation.